Hi there, welcome to the next challenge with Hackerrank. I really hope that I have been able to help you all in building up your Python skills, as well as your confidence in tackling these Hackerrank series of challenges. Today, we're gonna be talking about the capitalized one. I've got my Jupyter notebook to the right and my Hackerrank dashboard to the left. Just gonna go straight to tackle the challenge. You're asked to ensure that the first and last name of people begin with a capital letter. That's the routine. So we don't write our names like Chris Allen with a small C and then a small A. However, we use capital C and capital A for Chris Allen. So like always, this bottom part, feel free to ignore it at this point. The most important thing for you to understand is what type of input am I getting from the user? So it comes straight from the input function. Look, I will just quickly copy that. I'll paste it in my Jupyter notebook, run it, and my name is Amir Charhi, and that's it. So if I look at S, you will see that my name comes as a string, and this is super important, and is saved inside S. So going back, the most important thing, what type of input are you getting? The next thing is what is happening with the recipe function. So this is your recipe function. I've just been saying this for millions of times before. This is where you write, hey, I wanna make spaghetti, and this is how you make it. You write the recipe down here. Imagine that's the recipe. That's more complicated than, isn't it? And then you use this part to actually execute making the pasta. So let me get rid of that gibberish. I will write the word pass here for now. Pass means that, hey, Python, just don't do anything. Ignore it. I'm gonna come back to this. What do I do? What is the easiest way of doing this? Well, look, when you're getting an input like this, and it is two words that you wanna operate on every single one of them, just split them using the split method in strings. Look, now I have a list which has Amir and Charhi separately in it. Now I can perform whatever I want to perform. So maybe I will just make a new variable and I will call it new S so that I can perform stuff on new S. Let me just quickly print new S as well so you know what's happening. Look, there is a very helpful function called replace. So if I say, go to my new S variable that I have, and I want you to replace something with something else. So for example, I want you to take the first value in new S, which is Amir. Let me show it to you. So if I copy, you will see that what's its index 0 is Amir. So I want you to take that, and I want you to do a capitalize on that. So dot capitalize. Why did I do this? Because you can see that if I perform capitalize on this, did I paste it here? You will see that, hey, look, it just converted to capital A. So all I need to do is to capitalize that. But it's not gonna run here, because if I run that, you will see Python says, hey, look, you can't do a replace on a list object. And they're right. Replace is only used for a string. So you can perform that on a string. However, a new S itself is a string. So if I do this, you can see that, well, I can take a new S item 0, which is Amir, with a small a, and then I can replace it with something else. So this should give you an idea. How can I perform this in a programmatic way? So all I need to do is to make a for loop and say, for every part of the name in the s.split, all you need to do is say s.replace, and I want you to replace that name that was originally there by its capitalized form. And once you print S, you will see that you have Amir Charhi with capital A and capital C. So this is pretty easy. All I need to do is just copy these two lines, and I will get rid of that word pass because I only needed it for a short period of time. And once I do that, I can say return S. So let's run this code and see if it works. So like this video if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me grow my audience. Goodbye until the next challenge.